Good evening. On behalf of our entire community, it is my great pleasure to welcome each of you to St. George's. My name is Alixe Callen, and in addition to serving as St. George's 12th head of school, I'm also the parent of a current sophomore and an English teacher here on the Hilltop. And truly, as a teacher, a head of school, and as a mom, I am delighted to welcome all of you here. This is a really special time for us. It's like we get this glimpse into the St. George's of the future. And really, tonight's the night that the shoe is on the other foot. After months of working to impress us, and impress us you did, it's our turn to try to impress you. So tonight, I want to give you three reasons why I hope you will choose St. George's. First, our community. You will notice when I introduce myself that I introduce myself on behalf of our entire community. That was purposeful. The most important work we do here on this Hilltop is to prepare our students to be supportive and contributing community members. And in this world where people are more connected to their laptops than to each other, I want us to be a utopia. We want St. George's to be a place that sings with common purpose, mutual respect, pride, and lots of joy. Here at St. George's, students, most of the time, choose each other over Netflix and Fortnite. This is a place where community is at the forefront. To that end, there is absolutely always something happening on this campus. I'll give you a few examples. Last Friday, students went from an art opening in our art gallery to a faculty-student basketball game. On Monday, we gathered in the morning for our Winter Athletic Awards and in the afternoon for our annual Leadership Chapel. Tomorrow, our students will be cheering each other on the athletic fields, and on Sunday, they will have the opportunity to hear a guest speaker talk about the effect the Me Too movement has had on corporate America. And that's just this week. There is always something happening on this campus. We have more traditions and rituals than you can possibly imagine. The Christmas festival, the pie race, the paint dance, spring dance weekend. I could go on and on. And to some of you, that might sound all unicorns and rainbows, nice, but not very intellectual. In fact, we believe that teaching students to live in a purposeful, respectful, proud, and joyful community enhances our high academic standards. We understand from universities and businesses that they want students who know how to collaborate and how to interact. They want students who have what are called soft skills, the ability to relate to people different than they are, to listen, to demonstrate empathy. And here's the thing, you can't learn any of those things if you're sitting by yourself at home, but you can learn them at boarding school. Okay, second reason to choose St. George's, our academics. You will hear lots of schools talk about all the special programs they have, their trips, their special institutes, their partnerships, and yes, we have all of those things. But here's what I will also say. If you are a student here, you don't need to go to Costa Rica or Thailand to have your mind blown. We want this to happen every single day in our classrooms. I want us to be known as the prep school with the very best teaching. Our teachers work incredibly hard to create lessons and projects that are engaging and exciting. They teach you not only about math, English, science, but will also allow you to solve real-world problems. Just a few weeks ago, we were excited to receive the news that we are one of only 12 schools from around the country chosen to participate in a new program called Project Invent. It's a collaboration with Stanford, MIT, and Carnegie Mellon, where students develop tech-based solutions to real-world community problems. And if our students' work is the best of those 12 schools, they will be invited to travel to Silicon Valley to pitch their idea, a la Shark Tank, to tech executives out there. And indeed, looking ahead, we have even more plans. Starting next year, we'll be combining our departments in order to encourage deeper interdisciplinary thinking. While students will continue to, for the moment, to take courses in all of the traditional disciplines, our teachers will be grouped across those disciplines in five departments titled Humanities, STEM, Language and Culture, the Arts, and Connected Learning. What's connected learning, you might ask? It's our ongoing effort to connect our classrooms to the real world. This thinking, by the way, mirrors what is happening in colleges and universities around the country. Check out any college's strategic plan, and you will see interdisciplinary thinking prominently featured. Our work in this realm is really strategic. We want our students to be prepared for the demands of the most selective colleges and for the challenges they will experience in the real world. All right, third reason to choose St. George's. We're small. We are purposely, delightfully small. And let me tell you why that's a good thing. First of all, everybody knows everybody. As faculty members, we actually take pride in that, in knowing every student's name and something about them when we walk by them every day. As you make your way across this campus, you will see people, adults and students, greeting each other by name. People hold doors for one another, they cheer, and they champion each other. And that's tough to do in a big school, and not here at SG. Here's another reason why small is good. There is room for everybody to shine. Despite being small, we have all of the teams, all of the activities, all the leadership positions of a big school. Every student has the opportunity to carve their own path, to make themselves known. Each year, we select 10 sixth formers, which is what we call seniors, to serve as leaders of our school. That's more than 10% of the senior class. And it doesn't include the editors of the newspaper, the yearbook and the literary magazine, or the leaders of our clubs, or our dorm, library, and art center prefects. We offer 25 different sports, which means 25 opportunities to make varsity, 25 opportunities to be captain. And if we don't offer something in your area of interest, you can do an independent afternoon activity or start your own club. This year alone, students have explored painting, horseback riding, woodworking, sewing, robotics. Again, I could go on and on. And in each instance, have had the chance to share what they have learned with their classmates. In fact, this community works because every person steps up. Each person understands that they are critical to the very operation of this school. So what is St. George's? We are a small academic community where every student is known, challenged, and inspired. And I hope that each of you will get a chance to see and feel that for yourselves over the next 18 hours. On a personal note, I want to add that I want to meet and speak with each of you before you go. So if we have not yet met, I want to make sure that you do not leave this campus without connecting with me. So find me tonight, tomorrow, whenever. I want to connect with each of you. And if somehow this revisit ends and you are unable to get your questions answered, call us, email us. We will get back to you. I promise. Because that is the kind of community we are. And with that, I'm delighted to introduce Peyton Mulhern, sixth former, who will talk with you about her experience here on the Hilltop. Thank you all very much.